My name is Lindsay Thurston. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new here, Lindsay Living is where I love to share all my best home decor advice from shopping trips, DIYs, room makeovers, and more. Today, I'm going to be walking you through the top 12 items that I think you should definitely make sure are in your holiday decor collection. I'll be sharing with you some designer dupes along the way, and I'll be linking everything I can in the description box down below so you can find it while you're looking to round out your collection and get your home ready for the holidays. Before we get going, don't forget to hit that thumbs up. It lets me know you'd like to see more videos like this. I also want to give you a moment to head on down below and hit that subscribe button and the notification bell. That way you won't miss any of my future videos. I also have a series of Decorate With Me for the Holidays videos coming up, and you're not gonna want to miss them. All right, let's get into it. One thing that always makes my home feel ready for the holidays in that cozy fashion is a set of holiday pillows. I'm always looking for the right throw pillows to really transform my space. I'm gonna take out some of the navy blue in my family room, some of the more neutral tones in my living room, and replace them with a little beauty in some pillows. Now, if you were with me for my recent HomeGoods holiday shop with me video, you might have seen me pick up these beautiful, giant, cushy plaid pillows. These were only $19.99, and they are super duper smushy and cushy because they have a down insert. I also really love the little cord detailing on the trim. They have a zipper, so in case anything gets on these, I can just throw them in the washing machine. And these ones came from En Vogue Holiday Collection. Another pillow find that I couldn't resist on my recent trip to HomeGoods was this beautiful Joy pillow. This one has a very soft to the touch, almost velvet fabric. It's not real velvet, but kind of fakey velvet. And I love the font. I love that it's stitched and not printed on. And although I've said it so many times, I don't like word art or word pillows. One area I do is for the holidays, and it has to be just very simple. Probably this one will end up in my living room. And you guys will see that in an upcoming holiday Decorate With Me video. I'm gonna be doing my tree, my mantle, really everything to make that space just exude all the Christmas feelings. This pillow was from Homey Cozy, again from HomeGoods, and it was only $16.99. It's got that lumbar shape that I love. This would also be really pretty on a bed, either our bed or on our guest room bed. While you're out there looking for the cute holiday throw pillows, don't forget to find a coordinating, cuddly throw blanket that's subtly holiday, and really let those awesome pillows that you find shine. Good night. Next up, greenery or faux greenery. If you've been around this channel for a while, you know that I much prefer real plants to fake greenery. But the holidays is one big exception. It's fun to give your home a rich, just green holiday fir tree vibe, and I find that the only real way to do that is to bring in some faux greenery. Anything in the sort of fir tree category generally looks really good in a faux, and you can find a lot of really affordable styles pretty much anywhere. This is one of my all-time favorites. This little pine tree is fake. It's from IKEA from a few years ago. They get this style pretty much every holiday season. It's got just like a little base to it. You can just drop it into a cup or any kind of planter like this. This particular one is also from IKEA. It was only just a couple dollars. I like the little pop of red, but honestly, I'm a little bored with it. So I'm thinking about putting it into more of a rustic container, something that's in more of a neutral color, maybe beige or an ivory or some sort of stone texture would be really fun, just to give it a little bit of a new life. I've had this one for so long. I think it's time to try something new with it. So look out for that. Speaking of greenery, don't forget about things like garlands and of course, the big greenery, the Christmas tree. We really love to get a real Christmas tree. We've been doing that the last 2 years that we've been living in this rental house together. And I've been thinking, since I want to decorate so early this year and none of the tree lots are even open, they're doing more closures in our state because of COVID, I'm thinking about ordering another faux Christmas tree. And I've been scouring the internet to look for the best one. So if you have an idea of where I should look for the perfect faux Christmas tree, I'm looking for something that's 7.5 feet tall. I'm interested in something that's maybe partially flocked and then also something that's definitely pre-lit. Do you prefer a real tree or a fake Christmas tree? Go ahead, let me know down in the comments. I'd love to hear your thoughts. And if you have any idea where I should look for a faux Christmas tree for this year, definitely link those down for me below too, because I am hot on the trail looking for a good deal. Another little way to add in a little bit more fake plant life, I don't know if this is plant life, it's fake plant life, is these little bottle brush trees. I am absolutely in love with them. I think it's the mid-century lover in me. I just love something that feels like it was from another time. And these you can find pretty inexpensively in so many different locations. This set I found tons of last year in the dollar spot section of Target, or I guess now it's called Spots Playground. I can't tell. They came in all these different metallic glitter colors, different heights. This one's like a tall gold, these little mini ones, this one's silver, and then sort of more of a bronze color. And I like to just stagger them on a display like this. It just gives a little bit of a holiday vibe. And honestly, these were like $1 and $3, I think, for the tall ones. So incredible, incredible deal. I have even more, if you can believe it. I could not get away from that section last year. And honestly, I wish I'd bought about 15 more of them. I really want to do an interesting display either on a shelf or on my kitchen island or perhaps on my mantle. Another little thing I found in the realm of holiday decor at HomeGoods last week was this little light up LED mercury glass look tree. This one is from Cynthia Rally, New York. It's $12.99, such a great deal. And it came with batteries, which was really fun. So watch this. It's really sweet. It just has like this very subtle, bright, just kind of glittery feeling. It's got a little set of fairy lights on the inside that gives it that glow. It also uses just 2 AA batteries. Oh, it's like a whole holiday scene now. Check it out. Holiday scene.
Ooh.
Next on my list, I've got to tell you about my favorite ornaments. And that is ornaments from this company. It's called Old World Christmas. Oh my gosh, I have admired on my mother's Christmas tree for so many years. She's been working on a collection. I coveted them so much. I wanted my own collection. And my mama, she's so lovely and generous. She's really helped me to build my collection over time. And I know it's a little bit of an expensive item, but you know, when it comes to Christmas, I like to save money pretty much on everything. And then the one thing that I will spend a little bit more money on is Christmas ornaments. This doesn't mean that I don't like to integrate in some great budget finds from Target, which I'll be showing you in an upcoming video. I've got a lot of different kinds of ornaments, ones that I've DIY'd over the years. I'm gonna DIY some new ornaments this year. But one little splurge that I do love to indulge in is handblown glass ornaments from Old World Christmas. I will link this company down below. There are a million and one options. I just love how classically beautiful these ornaments are. They are so detailed, colorful, got little hints of glittery gold. This particular one is one that I got last year as a gift. I traveled for the first time to the city of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Amazing, amazing city. I want to go back. This one was a gift from my mama, kind of commemorating that trip. And it has a lot of the different landmarks that I saw while I was there. Now, these ornaments do tend to run a little bit on the expensive side. They can be between, I would say, about $8 and about $28. It really just depends on the style and the size of the ornament. They have a ton of different travel ornaments like this one, which I love to collect. They have these little tags that tell the name of the ornament. This one's called Philadelphia. And then it gives a little bit of a paragraph about why this ornament is so special and a little bit of the history of whatever that item is that it's depicting. My mom actually lives close to an Old World Christmas factory store where they have a lot of the clearance items, which are very hard to find. Every year she gifts me a few to add to my collection. This particular box has the 3 that I received from her, I believe 2 years ago. This one is the crayon. So cute because of course I'm an elementary school teacher. Oh my gosh, I get so excited when I open this paper, you guys. I can't even tell you. Oh, this is the one from when I got my puppy Kelly Green. So this is the little good dog Biscuit. Love this little one, reminds me of Kelly. Another teacher themed one. This one is, oh my gosh, it's a little mug with teacher's school supplies in it. So cute. I've got a ton of these ornaments. I have one that commemorates my college experience. I have, oh my gosh, I have one over here. I pulled my favorite one. And it's very unique, probably to me. I don't know if this would be everyone's bag, but I'm gonna go ahead and show it to you anyway. Truth be told, Halloween is my favorite holiday. Although I absolutely adore Christmas and I love decorating for the winter holidays, there's one most special ornament that always gets a prime spot on my tree. It's also an old world Christmas ornament. This one is their little jack-o'-lantern snowman. So he is absolutely adorable. He's got all the traditional stylings of a snowman except with that Halloween bent, and I just absolutely love this one. Oh my gosh, it's so fun. That's what's cool about old world Christmas. They really have something for everyone. Travis got one last year that commemorates our favorite football team, the Seattle Seahawks. Of course, hometown heroes around here. We've got ornaments to commemorate, obviously my teaching career, Travis's firefighting career, our dogs, different snowmen, different holiday themed items, different things that represent our personalities and likes. My mom even gave me one that has a pickle because I hate pickles and it's just funny. It's like a funny joke amongst our family. So it's like a charm bracelet for your Christmas tree. Oh, I just can't wait to put all these things on the tree. The next item that I'd like to recommend are these beautiful natural candles. This particular one is from HomeGoods. It was only, oh my gosh, $12.99 for this giant candle. This one is a real wick burning candle. And what I love about this style is it has this little bit of pine greenery, little pine cones, berries in here. It really gives it that natural holiday texture. I want to do a bunch of different heights of candles, maybe some tapers on a display on my dining table. Same exact price, $12.99. You can get it out of this little lantern. Bye, bottle brush trees. I'm gonna have a lab full of bottle brush trees here in a second. This is actually an LED candle. It just uses two AA batteries, has a little on and off switch. I really like how it does this sort of like flickering light, almost like a real candle. All right, little trees. Ooh. Mix it up. Those. Another style of ornament that I absolutely love on my Christmas tree are icicle ornaments. I absolutely adore icicle ornaments, and I have a set of very skinny, just absolutely stunning glass ones from Old World Christmas, but this year I wanted to add some more, and I must say, the Old World Christmas ones, while absolutely stunning, they're so skinny, we've broken several just barely by accident. I found another set at HomeGoods. These were six for $12.99 from Tahari Home. You can see they're a lot thicker and chunkier, which is nice. If they get knocked off the tree or anything, I don't have to worry about glass being broken in our home. And I just love how simple they are, and look how much they reflect the light. They're gonna provide a lot of just shimmer and glow, a little bit more ambiance in our holiday tree this year. While we're talking about ornaments, we probably should also talk about tree toppers. I've had lots of different kinds over the years, from a traditional star to an angel, but now I like something that's either very, very, very minimalist and natural or nothing at all. I have this really pretty twig tree topper from West Elm. I absolutely adore this one. Truth be told, I bought this tree topper probably about 5 years ago, but I feel like they generally have similar items every single year. And I love how they're either super natural, like this one is just twigs. It's got a little hint of iridescent gold texture, or they have some that are really mid-century in style, which I definitely prefer, especially for holiday decor. I can't imagine getting a new one, but you never know what I might find while I'm out there bargain hunting. I'll link some other ones down below so you can check them out. There's a ton of great options at West Elm, and they're usually not that expensive. Plus, there's tons of different sales leading up to the holiday, and after the holiday is a great time to grab some deals that you can use the following year. All right, let's talk Christmas stockings. I have quite a collection. I don't tend to get rid of them, and I've got some from my youngest years in my childhood. I like to just pull out different ones each year depending on the aesthetic that I'm going for. I got some new ones last year from Target, which I'm gonna show you. The first set I'm gonna show you are the oldest stockings that I can remember having as a child, and these ones are embroidered stockings. I absolutely love these. These are from Midwest Imports, I believe, and they're super traditional. And sometimes when I'm feeling that really traditional vibe, I like to pull these out and use these as part of my decor. Last year, I decided to get us some brand new stockings that were a little bit more aesthetic and simple. This is the one that I got for Travis. This one is from the Hearth and Hand collection at Target. I like how simple it is. This embroidered green pattern. Green is his favorite color, and it's got a little leather loop, and it's really pretty layered over other stockings, either solid colors or other subtle patterns. This is the one that I got for myself last year. This was from the Wonder Shop line at Target. They have a ton of great aesthetic holiday decor items, and stockings are definitely on that list. I love these little ball tassels. Green stitching all the way around the edge. Those were both pretty inexpensive. I believe they were both under $20. I also was able to get some solid color ones for our pets. Yes, I do like to put stockings out for our pets. This is one that I got from Pottery Barn years and years ago. This one's entirely velvet. You can get these in lots of different colorways, and then I used white stitching in a sort of a scripty print to spell my name. I pull this one out every now and again when I really want that green and red vibe. Okay, we've hit up ornaments, we've hit up stockings, tree toppers, pillows, throw blankets, greenery, bottle brush trees, because I can't get enough bottle brush trees. But one important thing that you don't want to forget, especially if you're decorating with a holiday tree, is a tree skirt or tree collar. There are so many different options. I remember when I was in my early 20s, the only options out there were pretty much tree skirts, and they were pretty simple or either so cartoony that it just wasn't my aesthetic. I feel like there's a lot more options now between different designer retailers, bargain finds, thrifted items, and tree collars. The first one I want to show you is this green felt option. I purchased this several years ago from West Elm. It's entirely green felt with a little bit of like, looks like almost like berries along the edge here with some ivory felt. I love these little leaves that are cut out. It's very natural. I do love this, and I got it on a great deal. West Elm had a big holiday decor sale one year, and I bought this and a bunch of other items, and I have loved this for many years. But one thing I would possibly caution you against is buying a green tree skirt. Green tree skirt. There was no real contrast. I just felt like a lot of green. That's why then I ended up switching to this more neutral one. This one is from Berkshire Blanket, purchased at HomeGoods. It's very, very simple. It was gifted to me by my mom. I still really love this one. It's got that sort of gold flecking to it, which is really pretty. I'm kind of wanting to go away from some of this like super overt gold this year. Don't quote me on that, but I haven't decided. But instead, I'm thinking I want to focus more on natural textures. So I'm gonna be bringing in this woven tree collar. Hi! This woven tree collar actually does have this sort of angled shape. Typically you would use it like this, where the angle goes like this to match the angle of the tree. But I've been seeing these styled differently, facing up like this instead. And I kind of like that idea, because then it feels like the tree is sitting in a woven basket planter, kind of like other plants throughout our house. Thinking about doing it like this. Woohoo! You can also find some in the galvanized metal, almost like a big metal bucket. Those can be really pretty too, especially if you're looking for something that has more of a farmhouse aesthetic. This one was purchased on clearance. It was only $35 after the holiday season a few years ago. I bought this one at Joann Fabric and Craft. I wouldn't say this is low quality, but I think they had this originally marked for over $100, and I just personally didn't feel like paying over $100 for this small piece of open top and bottom basket. Even if you don't have the money to buy this stuff for the holidays this year, check out the clearance sections of all these stores, Michael's, Joann's, all of our favorite retailers like West Elm, Pottery Barn, right before the holidays or right after the holidays for some great prices. I have way too many favorite ornaments to share with you, but these, the ones in this bag, are extra special. These are the ornaments that I purchased on our trip to France in February. We had planned this trip for about a year, and if I'm being honest, I've been planning that trip for my whole life. It was a dream come true to finally get to go to France, to visit Paris and the surrounding areas, and I really wanted to find some souvenirs that I could treasure forever and remember how special that trip was. Pretty much everywhere I went, I looked for Christmas ornaments, and I cannot wait to put these on my Christmas tree. Each one of these is so special to me for just really unique reasons, either connected to the trip or French history that I've been fascinated with my whole life. Oh my gosh, there's so many in here. I can't wait to see them again. I got all these at historical sites and museums around Paris, and each one is special to me in a different way. The first one is from a painting, one of my absolute favorites. The next is the symbol of the Sun King, Louis XIV. This one was purchased when we were touring Versailles. One of the major symbols of France. This is a fleur-de-lis, the gold and the pearl detailing. This one is so stunning. Next, I am a little borderline obsessed obsessed with reading information about Marie Antoinette and all of her escapades. This one is the official symbol of Marie Antoinette. You can see her initials here in the middle. And of course, the last one is Marie Antoinette herself in her full glory. These are all little blush ornaments. They've got really beautiful details like pearl buttons and lace and glitter and sparkle. And I just can't wait to relive our trip every single day seeing these on our tree. I would highly encourage you to look for holiday decor items like ornaments when you are out traveling. Someday we'll be able to travel again, and this is a really great way to remember your trip and to just add another little bit of your scrapbook of your life to your Christmas tree. I can't forget to mention little touches that you can add to your kitchen or bathroom through hand towels. I love to add holiday decor and little touches here and there just for that little subtle holiday feeling throughout my home. One easy way to do this is through hand towels in bathrooms and kitchens. Pretty much any retailer selling holiday decor is likely going to have hand towels, and you can find them in pretty much every decor style. This one from World Market has really cool antique feeling stitching that says Season's Greetings. I absolutely love this one. And this little set of three kitchen towels came from HomeGoods. These are from Kate Spade, New York. They've got that really fun mid-century feeling and so cute layered over some neutral towels in your kitchen. It's just fun to add little sprinkles of holiday everywhere, isn't it? Does anybody else ever just forget what they have? Honestly, when I was shopping last week at HomeGoods, I was struggling to remember some of the items that I had. So one thing you might want to do is pull your boxes out, look over all of your holiday decor items, and then make a list of what you're looking for to round out your collection before you shop, either online or in stores. That way, you'll get more of a cohesive feeling. You'll fill those holes that you seem to have every year in your decorating. I'm going to be filling some of the holes in my holiday decor with some DIY projects coming up soon, and I also plan to share a series of holiday decorating with me videos, so don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss it. For daily updates and photos of my home, don't forget to check me out on Instagram. You can find me there at Lindsay Living. Until next time, I challenge you to find one meaningful change you can make in your space this week, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye, my friends.